गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास विद द टॉपिक इंटीग्रेटेड रेट इक्वेशन फॉर जीरो ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. जीरो ऑर्डर रिएक्शन मीन्स एन इज इक्वल्स टू जीरो. नाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस लेट अस कंसीडर अ रिएक्शन इन विच ए गिव्स बी. सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू राइट रेट फॉर दिस रिएक्शन देन रेट is directly proportional to concentration of A raised to the power 0 because it is a zero order reaction. If I will remove the sign of proportionality, then rate is equals to K concentration of A raised to the power 0. And as we know, anything raised to the power 0 is equals to 1. So rate is equals to K. This is equation number 1. Also, according to differential rate equation, rate is equals to minus dA by dt. This is equation number 2. From equation first and second, K is equals to minus dA by dt. Multiply both sides by minus, then it will be minus K is equals to dA by dt. Bring this dt to this side, then it will be K dt is equals to dA. Now integrate both side. K is constant, so it will come outside. Then integration of dt is equals to integration of dA. With this integration, this derivative will cut. With this integration, this derivative will cut. Then what will left? That is minus k t plus integral constant is equals to concentration of A. In order to find the value of integral constant, let's consider at time t0, the final concentration is equals to the initial concentration, that is A naught. So now let's put this value in this equation. Then it will be minus k is equals to minus k into 0 plus I is equals to A is equals to A naught. So I is equals to A naught. This is the value of I. Now put this value of I in this equation. Then we will get A is equals to minus kt plus A naught. This is the integrated rate equation for zero order reaction. Now this reaction is similar to the straight line equation. That is y equals to mx plus c. Now if we will plot a graph between a and t, then we will get a straight line equation having slope minus k, and this point is equals to A naught. Now from this, if I want to find the value of k, then it will be k is equals to A naught minus A upon t. This is the expression for k. Now let's find out the half-life for zero order reaction. Half-life means it is a time in which half of the reactant or substance has reacted. Means at time t half, the concentration of A is equals to the half of initial concentration. Now let's put these two values in this equation, then we will get k is equals to A naught minus A is equals to A naught by 2 and t is equals to t half. Then k, let's take A naught common, then it will be 1 minus 1 by 2 upon t half. Then k is equals to A naught upon 2 t half. Now let's bring this t half here. T half is equals to a naught upon 2k. This is the expression for the half life of zero order reaction. Now if I will draw the graph between t half and initial concentration, then I will get the straight line having slope 1 by 2k. And as we know, for zero order reaction, rate is independent on the concentration of reactant. So if we will draw a graph between rate and this concentration, then we will get a straight line which is parallel to the x-axis. So this is all about zero order reaction. Now let's see some example of zero order reaction. First example of zero order reaction is that photochemical reaction. All photochemical reactions are zero order reaction. Second, decomposition of HI on the surface of gold is an example of zero order reaction. Third, decomposition of NH3 on the surface of PT is an example of zero order reaction. Now let's find out the expression or the integrated rate equation for first order reaction. Again, to understand this, let us consider a reaction in which A gives B. Now if I want to write rate for this equation, then it will be rate is directly proportional to the concentration of A raised to the power 1. Now 1, why 1 here? Because it is a first order reaction. Now if I will remove the sign of proportionality, then what will come? That is constant, then concentration of A raised to the power 1. So this is equation number 1. Also, according to differential rate equation, rate is equals to minus dA by dt. Then equation first and second, rate is equals to this and rate is also equals to this. So from these two, K concentration of A is equals to minus dA by dt. Now multiply both sides by minus, then we will get minus K A is equals to D A upon dt. Now bring this A this side and dt this side, then it will be D A by A is equals to minus K dt. Now integrate both sides, dA by A minus K integration of dt. Then integration of dA by A is log of A is equals to minus K. From this integration, this derivative will cut, then it will be T plus I, that is integral constant. Now again, in order to find the value of I, so at initial time or at starting point when t is equals to 0, then A is equals to A naught. Put this value in this equation, then log A naught is equals to minus K into 0 plus I, then I is equals to log of A naught. Now put this value in this equation, then it will be log A is equals to minus K T plus I is log of A naught. Now log A minus log A naught is equals to minus K T, then KT will be equals to log A naught minus log a. Log a naught minus log a. Now, log a minus log b is equals to log a upon b. Natural log is equals to 2.303 log log. Put this value in this equation, then we will get kt is equals to 2.303 log a naught upon a. Now k is equals to 2.303 upon t log of a naught upon a. Now as in this a gives b, so at time t equals to 0, when reaction has not been started, let us say the initial concentration of a is a and b is 0, then at time t, let us say the concentration of a is a minus x and b is x, because as you all know, with the passage of time, the concentration of a will decrease and the concentration of b will increase. So now let's put this value in this equation, then k is equals to 2.303 upon t log a naught, that is initial concentration, is equals to a, and a, that is final concentration, is equals to a minus x. So this is the formula for k. Now if I will draw the graph for first order reaction, as you can see, this equation is similar to the straight line equation, that is y is equals to mx plus c. So again we will get a straight line equation. Again we will get a straight line equation having slope minus k, and this point is equals to log a naught. Log a naught, where y is log a and x on x axis, what will come? That is t. Now this we also know, that is kt is equals to log a naught upon a. So if we will draw a graph between t and log a naught by a, then we will get a straight line equation having slope k. Now when we will calculate the half life for first order reaction, t is equals to t half and a is equals to a naught by 2. So k is equals to 2.303 t log a naught upon a. Now put this value in this equation, then we will get k is equals to 2.303 upon t half log a naught upon a naught by 2. Then a naught to a naught will cut, but will come log 2, and log 2 is equals to 0.3010. then it will be k is equals to 0.693 upon t half. Now bring this t half to this side, then it will be t half is equals to 0.693 upon k. This is the half life for first order reaction. Now let's do one or two question. For a chemical reaction in which A gives B, rate constant K is equals to 1.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 mole inverse square liter square second inverse. Then the order of reaction is, means in this question we have to find the order of reaction, and the value of rate constant with its unit is given. As we know, the unit of K इज इक्वल्स टू मोल पर लीटर 1 माइनस एन टाइम इनवर्स. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला टू फाइंड आउट द यूनिट ऑफ के. एंड इन दिस मोल पर लीटर माइनस टू सेकेंड इनवर्स इज गिवन. सो नाउ इफ वी विल कंपेयर दिस विद दिस देन वी विल गेट 1 माइनस एन इज इक्वल्स टू माइनस टू, एन इज इक्वल्स टू 3. सो इट इज अ थर्ड ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. लेट्स डू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. फॉर अ केमिकल रिएक्शन इन विच एक्स गिव्स वाई, इट इज फाउंड दैट रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन इंक्रीजेस बाय 2.25 टाइम्स व्हेन द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ एक्स इंक्रीजेस बाय 1.5 टाइम्स. फाइंड आउट ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन. नाउ इन दिस हाउ वी विल फाइंड आउट द ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन. नाउ एज वी नो रेट इज इक्वल्स टू के कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ए रेज टू द पावर एन. लेट अस से एट एनी टाइम टी जीरो, व्हेन टी इज इक्वल्स टू जीरो, रेट इज आर वन एंड कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ए इज इक्वल्स टू ए वन. नाउ एट एनी टाइम टी आर वन इज इंक्रीज बाय 2.25 टाइम्स एंड ए वन इज इंक्रीज बाय 1.5 टाइम्स. सो नाउ लेट्स डिवाइड दीज टू, देन वी विल गेट 2.25 आर वन अपॉन आर वन इज इक्वल्स टू के 1.5 A1 raised to the power n upon k concentration of A1 raised to the power n. R1 to R1 will cut, k to k will cut, and A1 raised to the power n to A1 raised to the power n will cut. Then what will left? 2.25 is equals to 1.5 n. 2.25 is the square of 1.5. So if we will compare these two, then n is equals to 2. So it is a second order reaction. Now let's find out the order with the help of graph. This graph is given to you and you have to tell the order. Now as you can see from this graph, it is clear that rate is independent on the concentration of reactant. So, as I have told you, for the zero order reaction, rate is independent on the concentration of reactant. So, this is the graph for zero order reaction. Second, this graph is given to you. And in this graph, it is clear that half-life is independent on the initial concentration. And for the first order reaction, the formula for the T half is 0.693 upon k, and it is clear visible from this that half-life is independent on the initial concentration. So this is the graph for first order reaction. Now let's start our next topic, that is molecularity. Molecularity is the number of atoms, ions or molecules participating in elementary reaction. Now what is elementary reaction? Elementary reaction means simple reaction, and simple reactions are those which takes place in single step. So molecularity is the number of atoms, ions or molecules participating in elementary reaction which must collide simultaneously is called molecularity. Or molecularity is simply the sum of the molecules of the different reactant as represented by the balanced chemical equation. It is important to note down here that molecularity cannot be more than 3, cannot be 0, cannot be in fraction, and cannot be negative. Whereas if we will talk about order of reaction can be more than 3, it can be 0, it can be in fraction. Molecularity we can find theoretically, whereas order of reaction we cannot find theoretically. It can be found only by experiment. Now let's see some example. For example, example number 1, in this 2NO reacts with O2 to give 2NO2. In this, it is clear that 2NO reacts with 1O2. So the molecularity for this reaction is 2 plus 1 is 3. But For this, we cannot tell order because it can be find only by experiment. Second example is 2H2 react with O2 to give 2H2O. Now in this molecularity is 2 plus 1, that is 3. Third example, 2FeCl3 react with SnCl2 gives 2FeCl2 plus SnCl4. Molecularity is 2 plus 1, that is 3. Fourth example, 2H2O2 gives 2H2O plus O2. Molecularity is 2. Fifth, KClO3 plus 6FeSO4 plus 3H2SO4 gives KCl plus 3Fe2SO43 plus 3H2O. Now, in this, the sum of reactant species is 10. So, which cannot be possible because molecularity cannot be more than 3. So, for this case, molecularity cannot be defined. Now, let's do next topic, that is pseudo first order reaction. To understand pseudo first order reaction, let us consider a general reaction in which A plus B gives B. Now consider in which one of the reactant is present in large excess and one of the reactant is present in small amount. The reactant which is present in the large amount, its concentration will remain constant because it is present in large amount. So for this type of reaction, the molecularity is 2. 1 plus 1 is 2, but the order of reaction is 1. It has been seen experimentally, the order of this type of reaction will be 1. For example, if ester dissolved in water, it gives acid plus alcohol. The molecularity for this reaction is 2, but the order is 1 because in these cases, order is dependent on the reactant species which is present in the smaller amount. It means rate is equals to K to the concentration of ester raised to the power 1. If sucrose dissolved in water, it gives glucose and fructose. The molecularity for this reaction is 2 and order is equals to K, the concentration of sucrose raised to the power 1. So, the order of reaction is 1 because the order will going to depend upon the concentration of reactant which is present in the smaller amount. So, according to this, pseudo first order reaction are such reaction which are not truly of the first order but under certain condition becomes first order. I hope you have understood today's topic. So, that's all for today. Have a nice day ahead.